And then thank you also to my dancers and actors. Without them, there is no way this would have happened. I was looking at a 150-page drama that would have taken about 6 to 7 hours to perform, and trying to condense it down to what we did, condense it down to about 2 hours. And that only happened because of my girls. So thank you very much. I don't think you can see them because they're off stage, but especially I'd like to thank Mancha. Woo! So the Lolita Madhava, I think many of you might have heard, Gurudev already gave you a short synopsis. The Lolita Madhava starts with what are called Nandi Shlokas. Srila Rupa Goswami wrote this drama using the Natya Shastra as a guide. And then he himself actually wrote a book called the Nataka Chandrika, which explains how to write devotional dramas. So it starts out with blessings and prayers in the form of poetry. Of course, the entire thing is poetry, Sanskrit poetry. Then it goes to the introduction, where Rupa Goswami himself, as the sutradhara, or the director of the drama, introduces the story through an exchange with someone called the Nati, who's basically just an actress. And that's where we find out that the anxiety of all of the devotees is, how will Radha and Krishna ever be united in marriage? There are so many obstacles coming in the way of their union. First of all, there's Shankachuda, who was sent by Kamsa to kidnap Radha. Then there's Kamsa himself, who is taking Krishna to Mathura. This, of course, is the biggest obstacle of all. And this causes a very, very traumatic situation, where in the Lalita Madhava, the gopis actually commit suicide. Now, we know they don't. There's obviously no death for someone who's in their eternal spiritual form. Radha and Vishakha are actually taken to the sun planet. But still, that's how intense their pains of separation are. So we'll be presenting the drama in two segments. The first one will be Acts 1 through 4. Act 1 is called an evening festival, where we're basically introduced to the joyous love and the playful pastimes between the gopis, specifically, of course, Radha, but all of the gopis, and Krishna. So the way we're presenting that act is we're only doing a short introduction that's from Rupa Goswami's writings, and we're actually presenting Narottama Das Thakur's song, Vrindavana Ramya Sthan, just to set the scene of how beautiful Vrindavan is, how happily everyone is engaged in their pastimes. Act 2 is the killing of Shankachuda. Act 3 is when Krishna is taken to Mathura. That one is called Maddened Radha. Radha goes crazy in the pain of separation. Act 4, which will be the last act of our first segment, is called the play meeting with Radha. So the setting of that act is that Krishna is in Mathura. He's in agony, feeling separation from Radha and all the inhabitants of Vrindavan. So to try to pacify him, Narada Muni sends these Gandharva actors and dancers to bring him back into the Vrindavan Leela. So they do a whole story about the tricky way in which he meets with Radha. As far as how we're presenting this drama today, we have a very limited crew. Because with COVID, we were trying to follow social distancing rules. So we have a core group of 5 dancers. They were already mixing together, and so they were following those rules. Eventually, 4 of us kind of joined, I guess you could call it their pod. So all together, there are 9 of us. Yes, all together there are 9 of us. But with such a small crew and so many characters, we've had to have, especially those 5 core dancers, play multiple roles. So please pay attention, watch very carefully to see how they switch from one actor to another. For example, in Act 4, the actor playing Krishna will switch to playing Abhimanyu. So what she'll do is she'll do a spin. spin, and she'll become Abhimanyu. So she'll first be Krishna. This is how Krishna stands. He's holding his flute. Abhimanyu is carrying a bag. Maybe he has gold. Maybe he has some goods to sell to get gold. He's money conscious. He's a businessman. So he's carrying his bag, and he's also an angry guy. So he has that expression. All right, so you can look at the expression. You can look at the way they're standing. So pay close attention. I'm going to very quickly go through how all of the actors stand, okay? Krishna, I showed you. Radha's like this. Chandravali's like this, or sometimes she might cross a foot over, but the hands are like that. Vishakha is like this. Lalita is like this. Purnamasi is like this. Vrinda Devi, she's got a parrot in one hand, she's blessing with the other hand. Mukra, she doesn't see very well, so she's squinting, trying to see, right? Then we have, let's go through the female characters. We have Madhavi, who is Rukmini's associate. She's like this, right? Then we have Sukanti, like this. We also just have some, I guess you could call them miscellaneous ladies. Bakula is like this. Gargi is like this. We have Pingala. She comes with the Shamataka jewel, so that's her. She's carrying the Shamataka jewel. I should mention, actually, the Shamataka jewel, Rupa Goswami uses that as like a dramatic element in the drama, where the sun god blesses Radha, or promises Radha that as soon as she's reunited with that jewel, she'll also be reunited with Krishna. So there's this anxiety that she needs to be reunited with the jewel. She got the jewel when Shankarachuda was killed, but when she went to the sun planet, the jewel was then given to Shatrajit. She was also given to Shatrajit, but he only gave Radha to Krishna or Satyabhama. He didn't give the jewel. So he's holding on to this jewel, and he needs to somehow give it to her in order for her to be reunited with Krishna. So yeah, Pingala's holding the jewel. Then we have Jatila. Jatila's got her fists on her waist. She's angry, mean. All right, so then going on to the male characters, I showed you Krishna. I showed you Abhimanyu. We also have Vishvakarma, who stands like this. We have Narada Muni, who's playing his veena, and he's got clappers in the other hand. We've got Uddhava, who's got one hand on his waist, one hand on his hip. We have Madhumangal, who's got two fists on his hips. Sometimes he's also popping laddus in his mouth, just kind of walking around, popping those laddus. Okay, so that's Madhumangal. We've got Kamsa, the evil king. We've got Shankarachuda, who's got fangs sticking out of his mouth. And then there's the miscellaneous kings. So we have Bhishmaka, who's like this. Dhammaghosha is like this. We also have the miscellaneous demons. Am I missing anybody? Shatrajit is also just a king. Yeah. So please watch this drama the way that you would study the books of the Goswamis, the way that you would read Prabhupada's books, with reverence and with great attention. This drama, even though we've abridged it and condensed it, it's got so many different layers. It's very complex. And the only way you're going to follow what's going on is if you really pay attention. Finally, I would like to ask for your blessings and also pray for your forgiveness, for any mistakes that we might make. Many of you watching may have already read Lalita Madhava. You may very much enjoy certain parts of it, and you may watch this and go, they skipped that out. For example, we don't have the whole part where Radharani is worshiping the sun god, and Madhumangal and Krishna are their priests. That is such a joyful part of the drama, and we don't have it. So please forgive us. It's of note that Rupa Goswami himself begs the forgiveness of the Vaishnavas at the beginning of the drama and at the end. So after watching this, if you have any corrections or chastisements, we will humbly accept them. And when we do another version later, maybe we can take those into account. And so without further ado, we present to you today Srila Rupa Goswami's Lalita Madhava.